Remember the 1970s TV sitcom What's Happening? What about Dee Thomas, played by Danielle Spencer in the sitcom? Dee has experienced a life filled with unexpected twists and turns that extend far beyond her time as a child television star. And recently, fans have uncovered disturbing details of how What's Happening allegedly destroyed Dee and her co-stars' lives. So, what exactly happened?
I always want to have a plan B because you just don't know with this industry.
One of the most tragic incidents in Dee's life occurred in 1977 when she was just 11 years old. On her way to the set of What's Happening, she was involved in a car accident with her stepfather, Tim Pelt. The accident claimed Tim's life and left Dee with severe injuries, including a broken arm, leg, pelvis, and facial injuries. She remained in a coma for 3 weeks and emerged from the ordeal with immense physical and emotional scars. Miraculously, Dee's strength and determination allowed her to recover enough to rejoin the cast for the next season of the show. She even sported a special hairstyle to conceal the injuries on her face. This pivotal event would go on to shape her outlook on life and serve as a testament to her resilience. Years later, life presented Dee with a new set of challenges. In 2003, she began experiencing numbness in her feet and legs, a development that would later be linked to the childhood accident. Dee underwent spinal surgery to address a spinal condition and had to navigate the arduous journey of rehabilitation. She spent 8 months in a wheelchair and engaged in intensive physical therapy to regain her ability to walk. This was no easy feat, but Dee's determination and willpower shone through as she tackled the obstacles head on. In 2014, another health setback rocked Dee's world when she received a breast cancer diagnosis. Faced with this new battle, Dee opted for a double mastectomy after consulting with her medical team. The experience was incredibly challenging, pushing her to confront feelings of helplessness and depression. However, the support of her friends and family played a pivotal role in helping her overcome the emotional hurdles associated with this difficult period of her life. But the story doesn't end there. In 2018, Dee underwent emergency brain surgery, yet another tribulation stemming from her childhood accident. This experience tested her strength and resilience once again, but she emerged from the ordeal with her characteristic determination intact. Despite the immense challenges she had faced over the years, Dee remained steadfast in her resolve to make the most of every moment and to find meaning in the face of adversity. Amidst the trials and tribulations, Dee managed to carve out a successful career as a veterinarian. Graduating from Tuskegee University, she dedicated more than 22 years to practicing veterinary medicine in the Los Angeles area. Her ability to persevere through personal challenges while simultaneously excelling in her chosen field is a testament to her strength of character and determination. However, the cancellation of What's Happening in 1979, not long after her accident, is a curious turn of events that invites contemplation. Could there be more to the story than meets the eye? The sudden termination of the show in close proximity to her accident raises questions about hidden narratives and the possibility that the producers might have harbored secrets best kept concealed. The subtle suggestion that maybe, just maybe, the show itself might have played a role in the unforeseen accident adds an enigmatic layer to Dee's life saga. In any case, Dee wasn't the only actor in What's Happening whose life was affected by the show. Let's look at Mabel King, who not only suffered because of the show, but eventually lost her life. Born on December 25, 1932, in Charleston, South Carolina, Mabel King's early years were shaped by her upbringing in Harlem, New York. Initially, her artistic journey was rooted in gospel music, a path she embarked on until her mid-30s when she transitioned into the world of acting. Her first notable roles included portraying Maria in Porgy and Bess during the late 60s, as well as her involvement in the Broadway musical Hello, Dolly. In 1973, Mabel marked her cinematic debut in the film Don't Play Us Cheap, directed by Melvin Van Peebles, coinciding with her appearance on the television series Good Times. The same year also witnessed her playing the role of the Queen of Maria in the horror film Ganja and Hess, a film later reimagined by Spike Lee as The Sweet Blood of Jesus in 2014. Nonetheless, it was in 1975 that Mabel King earned her breakthrough role, cast as the malevolent witch Evelyn in the Broadway adaptation of The Wiz. Her portrayal of the Wicked Witch of the West garnered her a Drama Desk Award nomination for Outstanding Featured Actress in a Musical. Following this pivotal achievement, 1976 saw her join the cast of the TV show What's Happening, where she took on the role of the mother. However, as the show progressed into its second season, discord arose between Mabel and the show's producers and writers. A significant point of contention was her weight. She was compelled to maintain her larger size despite her personal desire to shed pounds. This demand from the producers marked a turning point in her health trajectory. The enforced weight maintenance seemed to play a role in her subsequent health deterioration. In fact, after departing from What's Happening due to creative differences, Mabel King faced a series of health challenges. A diagnosis of diabetes and ensuing complications led to the amputation of her toes, legs, and an arm by 1986. In 1989, a stroke left her partially paralyzed and robbed her of speech for nearly a year. Her physical size further complicated her health struggles, culminating in numerous surgeries. Despite the obstacles she encountered, Mabel's friends and supporters rallied around her, providing her with a customized wheelchair for improved comfort. She relocated to Woodland Hills on Exhibit Court before requiring hospitalization for dialysis. Tragically, on November 9, 1999, Mabel King passed away at the age of 66 due to kidney failure. So tragic. Anyway, another What's Happening actor whose life got pretty messed up after the show was Shirley Hemphill, who played Shirley Wilson on the show. Born on July 1, 1947 in Asheville, North Carolina, Shirley drew inspiration from the renowned comedian Moms Mabley, who also hailed from her hometown. Following high school, she utilized her athletic scholarship to study physical education at Morristown College in Tennessee, driven by her desire to care for her mother. Post-college, she returned to her hometown and secured a job in a factory. Possessing a natural comedic flair, she honed her comedy routine through daily practice, entertaining her family and friends. During this period, she admired the comedian Flip Wilson, who significantly influenced her. At one point, Shirley's friends challenged her to record her comedy act on a demo tape and send it to Flip Wilson. To her surprise, he was impressed by her comedic talents and reciprocated with a new cassette tape recorder, roses, and an invitation to a show. This encounter solidified her decision to pursue comedy professionally, leading her to leave her factory job and embark on a journey to Hollywood. In Hollywood, she balanced stand-up performances at the Comedy Store with daytime waitressing to support herself. Despite the formidable presence of comedians like Richard Pryor, Shirley persevered, undeterred by the lack of immediate offers from Hollywood. Her determination ultimately caught the attention of John Murray, an associate of producer Norman Lear, who offered her a role on the show Good Times. Following this success, Norman Lear was so impressed that he extended an offer for her own spin-off show, which she declined. Instead, she joined the cast of What's Happening, a sitcom created by Norman Lear. Shirley's portrayal on the show resonated with audiences, but it faced cancellation after three seasons. Although her own sitcom venture, One in a Million, met a brief end after 13 episodes, Shirley continued her comedy career by performing in nightclubs around the world. In 1985, What's Happening was revived as What's Happening Now, introducing new cast members including Anne-Marie Johnson and a young Martin Lawrence. Shirley's support played a crucial role in helping Martin Lawrence through a challenging phase in his career, financially assisting him to overcome depression and adversity. Shirley's contributions extended to mentoring other comedians as well. She aided Rosie O'Donnell during her early days, offering her the opportunity to be the opening act for her stand-up shows. Additionally, she was an early guest on Oprah Winfrey's talk show when Oprah began her broadcasting journey in Chicago. While making guest appearances on various TV shows like The Love Boat, Trapper John, and Dee, Shirley's primary income source remained stand-up comedy. Later, when Martin Lawrence achieved stardom, he reciprocated by featuring her on his show, demonstrating his appreciation and support. Shirley's career also encompassed roles in projects such as Duck and the movie CB4 with Chris Rock, as well as collaborations with the Wayans brothers and other ventures. Tragically, on December 10, 1999, Shirley Hemphill passed away at the age of 52 due to kidney failure. Meanwhile, fans have not been silent about how the industry did these black actors dirty. One particular fan commented, "This is so sad what the industry will do to you." In any case, This isn't the first rodeo where black actors get caught up in the shady antics of Hollywood. But let's be real. When you look at the bigger picture, the heartaches that the stars of the sitcom What's Happening went through. That's a fate straight out of a soap opera, and not the glamorous kind. Anyway, that's it for this video, folks. Bye.